Okay, so members, in this lesson we are going to see how do we get the area between two curves. To start with, to get the area between two curves, now we need to get the limits. We are getting the area from what point of x to what point of x. In simple terms, we need a point of intersection of those two curves. So we start by getting the x values at the point of intersection, and they will act as the limit, those two points of intersection. So if I'm starting with this question, so that I have find the area equals between part 1, 2, and 3. We are going to see. If I have this curve and this, of course, you know that this is a line that is passing through the origin and then 1, 1. So, and then the curve, this one, we saw that this one is a standard curve which passes through the origin also. Now, the point of, we start by, we want the point of the intersection. Means, at the point of the intersection, this y and this y have the same value. So this will be equal to this at the point of the intersection. That's why I'm equating this to this. When I take this side, so that either x is 0 or this is the difference of the squares, I'll be getting these two. So this one now has 3 points of intersection. It has the one is here, then the 0, then the negative 1. Meaning, if it has 3 points of intersection, we are going to get that area 2 ways. So, we call this area 1, and this will be area 2. Those are the two areas now 1. So we shall get the area from negative 1 to 0, this is the area we want, and then this. So that's the area between these two at the points of intersection. So our area, first of all, so that this area is in the negative from here up to here, so it's the negative, meaning we shall get the modulus of that first area, then plus a 2. So we say that you get the curve above. In most cases, we consider when we have the one which is in the positive. So the curve above from here up to here, so that you see this line, this is the line y equal to x, and this is the curve y equal to x cubed. So in the positive from here up to here, so that this line is above. So we get the line above minus the curve below in this area. So now we get, now my first area is going to be from negative 1 to 0 of the curve above, we say you consider when the area is in the positive. So the curve above here is the line y, then minus this one down x cubed. This one means the curve below. This one a means above, this one below. So then the x then plus, of course, you shall get the one which love this, then from 0 to 1 of the above, which is the line, then minus the curve x cubed, the one of x. So here my area will be the same modulus. Can integrate this, we get x squared from negative 1 to 0, then modulus, then plus. The same when we integrate this, we increase the power by 1, then we divide by the new power. From 0 now to 1. Let us substitute the limits. So here my a will be now modulus into a, let me substitute the limits. The upper limit is 0. So we are going to be having the first is going to give us 0 minus 0, which is 0, then minus. When I substitute the lower limit, when I substitute the lower limit, I have a half minus a quarter. That's all. It's modulus, then plus. The same thing here, I'll substitute in the upper limit. The upper limit will give me a half minus a quarter, then minus a zero. So here is that we get, this will be negative a quarter. Here we shall get negative a half. Negative a half with this negative a half. Then we shall get, from here we shall get a half times a negative a half. Modulus of this, you shall get it as a half, then plus the same thing there, you are going to get a half. I mean a quarter. Here when we subtract this from this, we get a quarter. Then here when we subtract, we get negative a quarter times this, which is a quarter. And so our area is a half square units. When I come to this, the same idea, I start by getting the point of intersection. The point of intersection, this curve is going to be equal to this curve. So when I equate this to this and put everything this side, these are the points I get a point of intersection, x equal to negative 3 and 2, meaning that these are going to act as my limit. Now to sketch a curve, we need the intercepts. That's all. We say that if it's positive, if it's quadratic and it's positive, it's going to be having a minimum. And if it's negative, it's going to be having a maxima. Here you don't need to go through the minima, maxima, no. You just need to draw a sketch. So here is that this one is having a positive, this one is having a minima, this one is having a maxima. And we say these curves are very easy to sketch. If it's negative x squared, it's being like this. The intercepts are 9 there. We have seen that the intercepts are when y is 0, it's negative 3 and 3. That's why this curve is here and here, because those are the intercepts. When I come to this, when y is 0, we have negative 3 and 1. That's why it has the intercept there. It's minima because of positive coefficient and it's quadratic. So the area you want is the area here. That's the area you want. So that our area is going to be integral from negative 3 to 2. Then we consider the area above, the curve above. From here up to here, in the region of the intersection, this one is the curve above. So we get now 9 minus x squared. Then we subtract off the one which is below. The one which is below, we start this one is below this region. So this curve which is below, this is y equal to x squared plus 2x minus 3. And this is y equaling to 9 minus x squared. The one which is above, that's why I'm subtracting the above, then minus below, which is x squared plus 2x minus 3. The whole of this, yeah, dx. So you simplify that, so we'll be having from negative 3 to 2, this 9 minus minus, I'll be having 12, then minus, this minus, this minus, so I'm getting this minus, minus this, to give me minus 2, then this 9 minus minus, to give me 3, then negative x minus minus x, I'll be getting 2x, I mean 2x squared, then minus 2x, then plus, I mean minus, when you subtract to this, negative x minus this negative x, you get minus 2x squared. So that's all we have after subtracting the x. So let us integrate and see what do we get at the end of the day. So shall we have, we integrate this, we get 2x, 12x, then this will give us x squared, then this will give us minus 2 over 3 x cubed from negative 3 to 2. So we put in the limits. So now here our area will be equal to 2. When we put in the upper limit, we shall be having now, when I put in 2 here, I have 24. When I put in 2, minus 4. When I put in 2 here, I'll be having 8 times this. So minus 16 over 3. Then minus, putting the lower limit, which is negative 3, I have negative 36. When I put in negative 3 here, I have minus 9. When I put in negative 3, negative to give me a positive, and I cube 3. Because when you cube a negative, you get a negative. This negative will come to this. When you cube this one, you get 27 times 2. That's 54. Yeah, that's 54. Then divide by 3. That's 18 in brackets. So now, the answer you get, you just press your calculator. Allow me to do this. You just press your calculator. Let us see. This will be 20. This will be 20, this is 60, minus 16, 60 minus 16, that will be 44, yeah, 44 over 3, then minus, this will be 9, okay, this will be 9, positive 9, now you add on negative 30, 6, you get negative 27. The negative 27 plus this, you get now a positive 27, which will be, when you cross multiply here, you get your 2, 7 times 3. So you get 1, carry 2, this will be 81. Now 81 plus 44, I think you get 125 over 3. So this will be 125 over 3 square units as the area. Well, now I come to this between sine and cos, I start by getting the point of intersection. I equate at the point of intersection, this and this are going to be equal. That's why I'm equating them. If you divide 0 by cos, you get tan x equal to 1. Then tan inverse your x from here, so that your x will be tan inverse of 1, which will give you a 45. So cos is positive in two quadrants, this and this. So here it's 45. Then here we get 45 plus 180, which will be vice 225. So meaning that these two curves are meeting at 45 and 225. When you sketch them, we have seen how we sketch them. This is the standard curve for a cos, and this one is for a sine. And you see, this will be the point of intersection there and there. Then this is the area once. So now our area, you see, this time round is going to be the integral from pi over 4 to 5 pi over 4. When you combine this gradient, this one you get. Then the curve above on this in the region of intersection that we have, the curve above is sine, so it's half sine x. Then minus the curve below, which is cos x respect to x. When you integrate sine, you get a negative cos. And when you integrate cos, you get the positive sign, but it's already negative. That's why I have that. From pi over 4 to 5 pi over 4. If I factorize out a negative, the whole will be having cos x plus sine x from pi over 4. 5 pi over 4. Let me substitute. I have negative now into the upper limit. I have now into cos 5 pi over 4. Then plus. Then minus. When I substitute the lower limit, okay, let me see, this will be negative into, you see this angle, 2 to 5 is here, and the cos is negative, and also sine is negative. But you know that for the acute angle is 45, so cos of 45 is going to be root 2 over 2, it's a special angle. But because it's in this quadrant, and the cos here is negative, that's why I'm running negative root 2 over 2. Also sine in this quadrant is negative, the same, root 2 over 2. Then all of this minus pi over 4, which is 45, is here, it's a truth, and all of them are positive. So here we have root 2 over 2 plus root 2 over 2. So you see that here I'm going to be having negative into. Here, you see that this and this is going to give me a half and a half, will give me one. So I have negative root 2. Then minus the same thing here, minus the root 2. And this will give me negative into negative 2 root 2. When you add these ones and open brackets, so that your answer will be 2 root 2. Then these are square units. That's how we handle that. So remember, that's how we get the area between two cuts. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. I wish you the best.